Arvinda Singh Anand from Ericsson. We are in Mobile World Congress, Los Angeles, and today we are demonstrating you an end-to-end network slicing. If you see, for the slicing use cases, there is a requirement that you need to be on a distributed network where you can have cloud-native functions being distributed across for different use cases, for URLLC or EMBB. So today we are demonstrating, this is first time we are demonstrating, like the full end-to-end network slices with real equipment softwares. And as you can see, what I'm showing on the screens, you have the real UE that's coming from MediaTek that supports the 5G standalone. And then you have the real G-Node B, the 5G radio, which are kind of behind this wall. And you have this transport network. This is all set up in Los Angeles. And we have this Dallas, in Dallas Plano, we have the full 5G core network functions deployed in the data center. You have the service orchestration layer, the full lifecycle management of that slices. I'll walk you through how those demos, so you can see as you can create those network slices using Service Designer, which is part of the service orchestration. The service orchestrator is like open source compliant, ELC compliant, and TM forum compliant. As you create the slice templates and you start instantiating it, it creates those cloud native functions. These are 5G core cloud native functions stand alone. As you can see, they're starting registering into the NRF, which is the network registration function, and then it starts configuring the L3 VPN. And finally, you'll see that it kind of configures the RAN piece, which is the new radio, and it builds the end-to-end network slice and creates the pipe from the UE, right from the UE into the core going out from the UPS. So you can, this is like a first time we are doing that end-to-end network slicing. These are all physical, real software which is deployed in our data center. As you can see, I'm showing some of the screenshots of those real software, and this is the UE when we are using it, and this is the G-Node B which is kind of mounted behind the wall. And so from an Ericsson side, we are completely ready for you to switch 5G.